The new A-line assists are square tube or square steel, so they're really nice. They don't flex as much as a fiberglass. You set up the A-line assist, the best way to do it is take your wing, let's go over to our wing, and you take the risers on your wing. You measure your risers, the length of your risers, say your A-line. Okay, so we have our A-line right here where my finger is, and we measure the length of it. On this, it's 20 inches, probably around 21 inches for short. What you want to do is you want to make sure that this A-line has a minimum of 21 inches from the base of your A-line assist. So that means you have to add a minimum of 3 inches so that when the A-line is in place, it's got plenty of room. In other words, it's not being actually pulled down. What we like to do is we like to take your set of risers, measure from your hook end to the end of your A's, preferably your front A's. This has a split A system, outside A and inside A's. Keep that in mind. Remember, when you're using A-line assist, you always hook up the inside A's or the middle A's. What we want to do is we want to take the length from the bottom of the hook end all the way up to the top of the mallion on your A's. Let's say that's 20 inches. We want to add another 3 to 5 inches to that. Now, how you do this is you start out with about 5 inches. Say your line is like this, comes out like this. I think these are at 6 inches, because what we found with the specific wing that we're using on this craft that was called a Velvet, it can actually be launched with just a quick jerk, not even having A's. So what it would do is if you had it any tighter, it would go up perfectly, but it had a tendency to overshoot. So when this wing is flying, you have about that much slack in the lines. So there's a lot of slack there, but this specific wing is not heavy, so it doesn't hang behind. So what you'll notice is if you're flying and the wing is coming up and it kind of hangs behind you, then what you can do is tie a knot. Just tie a simple knot in the line on both sides and then test it, because each time you tie a knot, that's about a half inch. So what you want to do is do small increments at a time. Do not do anything large or drastic. Do another forward launch, take off. If the glider comes up this time and settles overhead pretty easily, then you got your A-lines adjusted just perfectly, or your A-line assist. These are great. It cuts things down for you. You don't have to do too much. Now when you're out in the field, when you're traveling around with them, it's good to just take them and link them together. And I'll do this real quick back in the video. So this is what I like to do when I'm out goofing around in the field with them, so I don't have to unbolt them. Because when you put your A-line assist in, they go through your regular CG hook in, and then you use the bolt that comes with it, which is a half inch fine thread, 5/16 with a nylock nut. So this puts the first board. Now a lot of people sometimes, if they make their A-line too long, if they don't want to tie knots, they might actually move this completely forward and then keep their CG where they are. This is a CG setup for anybody from around 275 down to around 200. It's pretty much, once you find the CG on this craft, it works for, you know, pilots 50 to 60 pounds easily in any direction. So for the most part, most people fly in the same CG point. The extra holes are for tandem flight. A-line assist. A-line assist, the easiest way to set up an A-line assist is to measure your risers. You have to measure from where they hook up all the way to the end of your center A's. And in most cases, you're around 21 inches, 20 inches, something of that nature. So then what you do is you take that 21 inches, you add 3 to 4 inches to that, and make your line. So we'll say it's 21 inches from the base here to right about here, and then add another 4 inches to your A-line assist. So we're going to hook this A-line assist up, not pulling too hard or too fast, because we don't want the wing to, it'll catch a breeze and try to come right up. So now watch, when the wing goes straight up, the A-line assist is holding the A's right about here. Now if you find that the wing wants to hang behind you a little bit and not come up, then you can tighten your A-line assist by just tying a knot in the string, you know, until you get it tuned properly. So you just put one knot in the string, and that's a good half inch, which keeps bringing it forward and forward. But what this is going to do is when the wing is in flight, this A-line is going to be right up here, which there should be some slack here. Got to make sure that you have slack in your A-line. You can't have it tight up against the rod. It has to have a little bit of slack so the wing can move in the air along with the Green Eagle and have no problem or not pulling on the A's. This is the reason why we designed this, because a lot of the older systems where you would tie a string here to the front of your craft if your craft porpoised at all in rough air, it would also pull your wing backwards and forwards, and we don't want that in the air. So anyways, this is your A-line assist system, so it's going to do all the work for you. What that means is that you don't have to hold the eggs. I'm going to hold my brake lines up for the main reason is I don't want to put any obstruction or I don't want to slow down my glider. Now, if my glider comes up overhead really, really fast, you might see me do a double pump to stop the glider from overshooting me. All right, clear prop. Here we go. Got to get ready to go.